The Grammys are tonight. We're here now with our entertainment attorney, James Walker. Big night, all the entertainers out there. Usually someone steals the show. Quick prognostication. Who steals the show tonight at the Grammys?
Well, there are a couple things. The guy that's dead is going to steal the show, one being Michael Jackson, mm-hmm. with the biggest tribute of all being made to he and his music and his legacy. But I think Beyonce is going to steal the show.
You think so? Lady Gaga?
I think Beyonce is going to steal the show.
Not Taylor Swift?
Nope. I think we've gotten over the Kanye West, Taylor Swift apology. However, I think Song of the Year... Record of the Year, maybe Taylor Swift.
Well, hang on, you're going ahead of us. Well, let's talk. We'll get to the break. We'll get to the walks picks in a second. But I want to, so you think, you don't think Lady Gaga, see, now you're much more of a veteran here. I'm a novice at this, but I'm looking at the tea leaves here. It just seems like this is Lady Gaga's year. I don't even know her song, but it seems like she's it thing, right?
Poker Face from the album The Fame. I think right now she's it.
Right.
But Beyonce is it, capital IT.
Okay.
The Beyonce Jay-Z factor, who is also nominated, by the way. And I just think we're going to have a great show. I'm looking forward to it.
All right, now we'll go to the walks picks. We're going to pin you down a little bit and see. Let's start with best song. And we'll do best song, best album, best record, and okay. go from there. So, walks picks. Let's start with best record of the year.
Record of the year. I think our winner, I'm giving it to Taylor Swift. A little bit of sympathy vote here, but I think You Belong to Me is such a great song. I think she might pull one over on Beyonce with Halo. You know, there was a lot of issues with Halo because a couple people did the song. I think Kelly Clarkson did the same track or something, and Beyonce did it. And
Halo.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. We won't sing. You'll lose all your viewers.
Now, your sleeper is Beyonce, though.
In that category, yeah.
Okay, but you think Taylor Swift will win this one?
I think Taylor Swift will win that one.
Album of the year?
Beyonce.
Okay.
Beyonce.
Without a question.
Without a question, I am Sasha Fierce. I have to give it to Beyonce. I just don't see how Taylor Swift could be Beyonce when it comes to overall album of the year.
But your sleeper is Taylor Swift.
Yes, my sleeper is Taylor Swift.
Song of the year.
Song of the year, I'm mixed on that one. At first, I went with Taylor Swift, but then I thought, I talked to my kids, I talked to some of the young people in my office, and everyone's singing Put a Ring on It. Single Ladies, Put a Ring on It. I mean, the dance, the moves, YouTube ran that thing a million times. I would be very surprised if Beyonce didn't win for that song.
And your sleeper there is?
My sleeper there is Taylor Swift.
All right, so what we're hearing, though, with your Taylor Swift and the Beyonce thing going on, right?
Correct.
All right. So Gaga then gets sort of just shut out of the picture on this?
I think she's going to surprise us and take one, but you remember the year when NDRE had 6 or 7 nominations and Alicia Keys came and just... destroyed her with 7 or 8 wins.
She's not there yet.
I think Beyonce and Lady Gaga are going to be like the year when we were all shocked that NDRE didn't win any against Alicia Keys. I think it's the establishment against the new kid on the block.
Mm-hmm. Now, how do you leverage this? If you are a new kid on the block, mm-hmm. and you win a Grammy. I mean, this means what to the portfolio and your peers? What's this mean?
I should point out we have clients nominated, too. I don't want to overlook them.
Okay.
But what it means for you if a client is nominated and actually wins, it's an increase in record sales. I mean, that's the most exciting thing. Simple as that. You know, you come out of because right now you're asking questions about Lady Gaga, mm-hmm. Poker Face, Fame. In the rap category, we got Eminem, Jay-Z, Flo Rida, Universal, Mos Def, Common from Universal Records, and Mos Def with Casa Bay. All of these artists need a push from this show. This is the biggest music event, the biggest music night. So if you win and clean up, even the casual listener tunes in to say, well, who is Lady Gaga?
Mm-hmm.
Well, who is Common? Well, who is Mos Def? And I think that's what's wonderful about the show.
So record sales raises your take at concerts, raises your appearance fees for record concerts?
Record sales and award wins raises your appeal at radio. Mm-hmm. Radio has to play the record now if Lady Gaga wins 5 that night. Or Beyonce wins, 8 that night. Record radio programmers go in the next day and say, hey, we need to start playing this record.
And sponsors start saying, if they're attracting this kind of audience, maybe we should attach our product
now,
with that person.
Before we wrap up, we should point out Kanye was snubbed. Mm-hmm. And a lot of that had to do with the whole Taylor Swift thing.
We'll talk about that then. That was an intentional snub. They froze him out. Punishment.
Kanye was snubbed and Whitney was snubbed. They rushed to get that record out there. The record is almost platinum, and Whitney didn't get a single nomination, which we needed a nomination for her to signify this is her comeback.
Well, walk us through that then. So who's to blame there? Is it strategically the fault of Whitney and her people, or is it more jealousy on the industry?
No, Whitney had a couple of poor performances on Good Morning America. She did just okay on Oprah. She's done a couple concerts in Russia, but she's not the Whitney of old.
Mm-hmm.
And the core base is buying the record. That's why it's at 1 million. But they expected 3, 4, 5 million. And nothing really caught on. It's almost like this generation has passed her, and the record just never caught
on. Interesting. So conversely, now, what does that mean for her when you're basically saying she bombed here to some degree?
By Whitney Houston standards, if you've sold over 100 million records and this record is creeping at a million barely after 8 or 9 months, I mean, yeah, it's not a big record by Clive Davis' standards.
Interesting. Now, you mentioned Michael Jackson in passing. His DVD also is dropping now. You're going to have a tribute to Michael Jackson tonight.
Right.
DVD sales will continue to bring this whole thing, you know, to the next level as far as sales. Your thoughts on where this finally ends? You've talked a bunch about having a legacy a la Elvis for MJ at some point. Where does that go? The family still seems to be sort of at odds.
The family's still not on one accord with regards to doing a tour or doing some kind of biographical big movie. However, the family is in agreement with regards to honoring his music legacy at the show, and I think most of the family probably will be there, including his kids. There's talk that his kids might perform, but I think they've got a vault of songs. Remember, he did 469 songs for Motown and maybe released 180, 200 of those songs.
So we can see more.
So we could see a lot more releases coming out. Unfortunately, the family doesn't make any money when Berry Gordy separated with the Jackson 5.
Oh, really?
He kept most of the rights to those songs.
Oh, I didn't
correct.
Know that.
And he blocked them out where if they released those songs, the family released all future royalty rights on a lot of those songs.
Oh, okay.
So Berry Gordy could see, you know, Motown, I should say, not Berry Gordy, Motown could see a lot of money come in from posts.
But the family does not own the rights.
The family does not own the rights. Berry Gordy has the name the Jackson 5. The family has the name the Jacksons.
That's why
they perform under the Jacksons.
Real quick, 36 segue. Howard Stern, Clear Channel, the story this week. Clear Channel said that they may have interest in bringing Howard Stern back. $500 million contract expires this year. 10 seconds.
No way. If we let Stan go in the bar and be Stan in the bar, he's not coming back to Fox, where we're going to keep you kind of under a watch and not let you have freedom of speech. Right now, he's on a network that allows him to say whatever he wants.
All right. He's James Walker, our entertainment attorney. When we come back, we'll talk about a troubling and provocative practice that a number of young people are engaging in called sexting. Don't go away.